Hello there. This is Lady May, and I am wishing you a wonderful, exciting Mother's Day.
I want to love you, love you, I praise you, Lord. I praise you, Lord. Come on and praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord and happy Mother's Day. God bless you. Please join me as we turn to the Word of God. Our scripture reading is taken from Proverbs 31, 25 through 28. Strength and honor are her clothing. She shall rejoice in time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and on her tongue is the law of kindness. She watches over the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his word. Amen.
God's creation. If it wasn't for God, we wouldn't exist. He made us all, and there's one thing he wouldn't miss: the qualities of a mother and all it takes to raise his children in his created place. He knew just what he was doing. Oh yes, he did. For when he made woman to care for kids, he gave her strength, he gave her patience, he gave her unconditional love. Oh, what a special creation. Thank you, God, for making mothers so amazing. I'm especially thankful for mine and all she's done raising a child like me, full of curiosity, raised with love and filled with possibility. Happy Mother's Day. I love you, Mommy.
Good morning. I am so happy to be on this platform with you all. We may not all be able to be together, but we are together in spirit. I am Janine Blake, and I'm so happy to have prayer with you on this Mother's Day morning. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you so much for Bishop Blake and his vision. We thank you for Lady May Blake and her vision. And we are so thankful to be able to have this program on today to give you glory. We are so thankful for everyone that has tuned in, for everyone that's a part of this program on today, because this is a program that is going to give you glory. And it's going to give everybody that's watching it and that hears it, whether it's today or later, it's going to give everybody a big boost and uplift, because we are drawing closer to you in your word. Please let your Holy Spirit rest on this service. Let your Holy Spirit be with every presenter, every singer, and everyone that's on this program. We especially thank you today, Father God, for the mothers, for this is Mother's Day, and we are celebrating mothers, grandmothers, biological mothers, stepmothers, mothers of the church. They all help lead us to your marvelous light. And we thank you for mothers. We even thank you for mothers of dogs and cats. These two are mothers that are taking care of your creation. We are so thankful, Father God. We just can't thank you enough. So we just want to give you glory and praise, and we lift our hands and we say hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to your glorious name. You are matchless. There is none else like you, Father God. And we thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for being just who you are. We ask for your spirit to rest on us throughout the rest of this day. And I also want to pray for those mothers who are in prison. Father God, if it's your will, let them be able to be joined again with their children. We know that you are in families, Father God. It's your purpose and it's your plan for families to be together and to worship you together. Let that be our desire and our prayer, Father God. And once again, we just thank you. In Jesus' holy name, amen.
Greetings and peace from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Welcome to West Angeles. Today is Mother's Day, and we are so happy you have chosen to spend a portion of Mother's Day viewing our online worship service. It's going to be special. As we continue to navigate these difficult times in our nation and world, we wanted to take a few moments to honor and give a shout out to all mothers today. New mothers, old mothers, mothers who have passed away, mothers who have lost children, mothers who bore us and gave us life. One of the Ten Commandments tells us in Exodus 20:12, honor your father and mother, that your days may be long upon the land which the Lord your God has given you. We often hear appreciation for those who work on the front lines, making sure we have food in the stores, in addition to people responding to emergencies, and other professions that are truly a blessing to us all. And we are more than grateful for their service and sacrifice. One of the things we hear is that someone who is an essential worker not only can go to work, but are expected to go to work. The pressures on all these people have been profound. So keep them in your prayers this week and in the months ahead. But this title, essential workers, before it became popular, it has been long associated with the lady of the house called mom. What would we do without mom? Boy, talk about profound pressure. Some of the essential work of this glorious, unselfish, risk-taking person will be brought to mind within today's program. We hope you'll enjoy it. But before I go, here's a little story. A teacher gave her class of second graders a lesson on the magnet and what it does. The next day, in a written test, she included this question. My name has six letters. The first one is M. I pick up things. What am I? When the test papers were turned in, the teacher was astonished to find that almost 50% of the students answered the question with the word mother. Happy Mother's Day. We honor you all today. God bless you.
To get a hold of me, your love is so much stronger than whatever troubles me. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you and believe. Oh, forgive me, Jesus. I thought I could control whatever life would throw. Brought me to my
Good morning, church. I give honor to our pastor and first lady. Happy Mother's Day to all mothers. Thank you for the privilege to allow me to offer a tribute to mothers. Mothers, we honor you today. Do you not know that next to the birth of Jesus, your birth as a woman and your selection to bring forth a child was one of God's greatest gifts to the world? He chose each of you mothers to populate the earth. How wonderful, how magnificent, how glorious was that? Mothers, you are God's representative on earth. God gave us his son Jesus through his mother Mary. He was born, died for our sins, rose again. Now, according to the Bible and in Romans 8:34, Jesus is at the right hand of God making intercession for all of us. Mothers, I submit to you that according to Maybelline 2021, you sit on the left hand of God, pleading and interceding for your children. Mothers, your spirit is more like God's than any other creature on earth. You were specifically chosen by God to be born. Not only that, you were also specifically chosen to give birth to every child that you birth. Your gift of motherhood was not by happenstance. It was by design. God chose every child that he formed in every womb to be born, and he did so for a purpose. According to Jeremiah 9:5, I formed you in your mother's womb. Before you were born, I set you apart and appointed you. The child you created, no matter the circumstances of that child's birth, was ordained by God to be born. For you mothers who did not give physical birth, but you gave life to such child as a stepmother, a grandmother, adopted mother, foster mother, God specifically chose you to mother these children, for your spirit is like his spirit. Mothers like God, you give life, not GE. God creates human beings through you. And like God, you love unconditionally. Like God, you forgive your children over and over more than 70 times 7. Mothers, like God, you provide for your children from sunup to sundown. You rise up early, preparing your household, and you rule your household well. Mothers, like God, you pray for your children while they slumber. And like God, you often know what your child has need of before he or she asks. You anticipate the needs and do your best to fulfill each need. Mothers, you are more learned in many subjects than those with degrees. You have innate wisdom. You budget better than most CEOs. You add faster than any CPA or calculator. You know what the grocery bill will be before the grocery store clerk gives you the receipt. Mothers, you are creative and resourceful. You know how to make a meal from little or nothing. From leftovers, you make sweet desserts like bread pudding and rice pudding. From bread crumbs, you make that delicious Thanksgiving dressing. Mothers, you can stretch a dollar to pay rent, buy diapers, buy food, keep the lights on better than Motel 6. Mothers, you robbed Peter to pay Paul without ever committing a crime. You deny yourselves often, putting your children's needs before your own, buying them new shoes and wearing runover shoes or going without. Mothers, just like Jesus, you are unselfish. You make sure your children eat, even if you just drink water. You are geniuses. Did you know that? You know how to make a quilt or covering for your children from scraps of material. Mothers, you are for comfort for your children, just like Jesus. Your children who are heavy laden can come unto you and cast their cares upon you. You wipe the tears from their eyes. Then you take their cares to Jesus and intercede on their behalf. Mothers, you carry your babies on your lap and your adult children on your heart. You never give up on them. Mothers, you always find time for your children, even if it means denying yourself adequate time to eat or sleep. And like Jesus, you can feed a multitude with little. You can take that 1 pound of hamburger meat and 1 cup of rice and stretch it to feed the whole multitude in your household. Mothers, you are lawyers without degrees, always pleading your child's case, defending and standing up to those who wrong your child or mistreat your child. You're like doctors. You treat their ailments with homemade remedies. And often like Jesus, just a touch from you will stop the pain. Mothers, you never judge your children. You discipline without judging, and you love them no matter what. You know the art of sacrifice. You sacrifice your happiness and joy for the sake of your children. And no one can love your children more, treat your children better, provide for your child's needs better than you, but Jesus. Mothers, God chose you to bring forth prophets, kings, queens, bishops, elders, teachers, politicians, doctors, lawyers, engineers, plumbers, auto mechanics, electricians, scientists, astronomers, policemen, firemen, EMTs, and even the street sweepers. Mothers, it is the creature that is formed inside of you that rules the world. Your hands rock the cradle. All human life comes from you. Do not allow the devil and anyone else to fool you to believe that you are the weakest link. You are the most powerful link after God. For these and more reasons, we salute you, mothers. Our prayer for you this day is that you will prosper and be in good health, even as your soul shall prosper. May the Lord watch between you and me. May the Lord make his face shine upon thee. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you peace. Happy Mother's Day, May 9th, 2021.
Oh, Greetings and happy Mother's Day. My name is Christiana Davis, and I have the pleasure of being here with my mother, Mika Robinson Davis, and my grandmother, Evangelist Sonia Robinson. On this Mother's Day, we've come to kind of just have a candid conversation about our journey and about the significance and the role that West Angeles has played in our lives thus far. So, grandmother, of course, you have been at West Angeles for quite some time.
Yes.
And I think that your journey is a unique one for so many reasons, because it shows the saving power that West Angeles has allowed you to see. So tell me about that. I've never really had the opportunity to have this conversation with you like that. So tell me, what is that like and what has it been like?
West Angeles was the beginning of my spiritual journey. There was this beautiful little church on West Adams that I decided to attend. And Bishop Blake and Lady May were the ministers of this ministry. And I would go on Sunday by myself, because we weren't saved. The family wasn't saved. And I would go and I would listen, and I accepted Christ.
And That's awesome.
As my Lord and Savior. And when I did, as I would go, I brought the children. And of course, your mother is the baby, and the others, four daughters, of course. And we would attend service. And they began to become active in Sunday school and all of the activities of the church. And we began to grow. They got saved, filled with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My husband was at home at the time. But I do remember a scripture in Acts 16:31 that said, "Believe in the Lord, you shall be saved, yes. You and your house."
Amen.
And I stood on that scripture, Christy. It was a living word.
Yes.
And I wanted my house to be saved. I wanted everyone in my household to be saved.
Amen.
And so I also read a scripture in 1 Corinthians 7:14 that said that the believing wife will sanctify the husband.
Yeah.
Yes. And so I just believed God that he was going to do that for me.
Yeah.
And he did. Clarence did come. He was saved. He was filled. He was a member for 44 years.
Amen.
Until his demise.
Yes.
And so I was developed at West Angeles.
Yeah.
I learned. I grew in the Word. I learned to be a good mother.
Yes.
I learned how to live holy.
Yes.
Bishop Blake and Lady May were great leaders.
Yes.
That I gleaned from.
Excellent.
And what I saw holiness.
Amen.
And it was just a wonderful experience. And of course, I'm so grateful and thankful for this time that I have here.
Yeah.
Because this is home for me. This is my foundation.
Amen.
Yes,
and
I think
one of the things that I love that you mentioned is that power of the salvation and the sharpening that Proverbs talks about, right?
Yes.
How as iron sharpens iron, so can one man sharpen another. And so West Angeles has been that iron that the family has needed, and even you as a mother and a wife have needed. And so, Mom, I know your experience is obviously something very different, because our interactions with the church and with God and with salvation are very different. And I know that you can really speak to growth, right?
Yes,
in a way.
Most definitely. Well, West Angeles has been a place to gather, a place to worship the true and living God, a place to surrender, a sanctuary, a safe haven, Christy. It's just been everything that you want to do and go to with for fellowship. We've just been not only a church, but a family.
Yes.
I've learned so many things over the years, such as not to take anything for granted, but to be grateful for everything.
Amen.
Yes, and I've also learned to cherish all of the lessons taught, because they have been pearls of wisdom.
Yes. I love that you talked about wisdom. You know, I think as the third generation, I think that we have a very interesting approach to salvation and to understanding God and to understanding his word and churches all together. But I think I love West Angeles because I've had the opportunity to grow and to mature and to become wiser under some phenomenal leaders.
Yes.
I can't help but, you know, think of my experience serving as worship leader under Dr. McAllister, and having the opportunity to, you know, travel on mission trips through the leadership and the influence of our our pastor, presiding bishop emeritus, Bishop Charles Blake. And so having those opportunities and the wisdom that I've been able to glean from has been priceless for so many reasons.
Yes, and I've also been able to witness the strength, humility, hard work of our leaders, yes, moving the church forward and always being a beacon of light,
yes,
where God has always been the center.
Yeah, that progression, I think, is something that I'm so grateful for. And even as I continue to grow and mature, and as we all do, right?
Because yes,
we still have so much work that needs to be done. We can't help but be incredibly grateful for the life and for the gift that is West Angeles. So,
and then, of course, I do want to say that it's such a wonderful experience to see my family grow, to yes, see my daughters grow and yes, evolve, to yes, see you, Christiana, evolve yes, and what God has done in your lives, and to see what God did in my husband's life.
Yes.
And I just thank God for Bishop Blake and Lady May and yes, their leadership.
Yes.
And because they have made a difference
yes,
in our lives
yes,
as a family. Exactly. And of course, my oldest daughter is a first lady. She's in the ministry. Mika is also, and Kimberly. And you, of course, Christiana. And it's just wonderful to see that God kept his word.
Yes.
His word
yes,
is true.
Yes. 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 He honors his promise. And so yes, with that, we just want to say to you, Presiding Bishop Emeritus, our pastor, our leader, mm-hmm, and to the fragrance of this house, his, yes, as he says, his secret weapon, our First Lady, mm-hmm, Lady May, thank you for giving us this opportunity to share our story and our journey. Lady May, thank you for being a standard, for being a woman of grace and integrity and beauty and love and honesty. We appreciate
yes,
you.
Yes.
We love you. We yes, celebrate you. Happy Mother's Day to you and to all of the other mothers at home worshiping virtually. Happy Mother's Day. Enjoy your day. God bless you. God keep you.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
Pandemic for over a year now, and it has caused a lot of anxiety for some and depression for others. It has created financial hardship for those who've lost jobs and heartbreak for those who have lost loved ones. But the Bible says in Nehemiah 8 and 10, do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. And if when you have a relationship with Christ, you just can count on the fact that no matter how dire your circumstance, no matter how traumatic things are, you too can still have joy. You can have joy, you can have peace, you can have faith, hope, and never ever forget your praise. I still have joy.
I still have joy. I still have joy. After all the things I've been through, I still
Hello, my name is Yvonne Buchanan. I am a proud member of West Angeles for more than 40 years. Before I begin my testimony, I would like to wish a very special Happy Mother's Day to our First Lady, Lady May L. Blake, one who is elegant, loving, caring, and kind, always giving us pearls of wisdom. My testimony today is to share with each of you the profound anointing God has placed within our pastor, Bishop Charles E. Blake. Prior to the pandemic, I had major surgery, a hip replacement. The surgery went well, however, it left me with excruciating pain. The surgeon sent me home with an enormous amount of opioids. And after taking them for a couple of days, I realized they were causing more harm physically and emotionally. The pain would subside, but the effects they had on my body and my mind was such that I knew opioids were not for me. My doctor told me I could return them to the hospital, which I did, and take Tylenol extra strength. Little did they help.
when I was able to return to church, I was in such pain, but determined to get there. I felt like the woman in Mark 5 that knew if she touched the clothes of Jesus, she would be made whole. With this particular Sunday, I practically crawled to church. I was in extreme pain, but I knew if I could make it there, I would be healed. So I anointed myself with the blessed oil that Bishop Blake blessed, got dressed, and made it to church. After Bishop preached, he called for those who had pain or health problems to come down to the front. As fast as I could, I went to the front. Bishop prayed, and immediately I felt the pain leave. I went back to my seat crying. Bishop asked if anyone felt they were healed, and I raised my hand. He had me come down to the front and tell what happened. Bishop Blake, I thank you. I have not had hip pain since that morning. God truly anointed you to speak healing through my body. You are such an anointed man of God and highly respected. You are a gift to not only this church, but to the body of Christ as a whole. Thank you and Lady May for real leadership. I find no fault.
Giving is a measure of one's love for God. Giving is also an expression of our faith. James chapter 2, verses 15 through 17 instruct us that a believer's faith is at its best when it is expressed through works. The work of giving, therefore, is a show of one's faith. The believer is not saved by works, but the believer shows their faith through their works. I give because I have faith in the Word of God, and I have seen God make something out of nothing. I've seen God make unmeetable ends meet. So giving may cost us something, and it's definitely a sacrifice to God. But just as God sent His Son, which showed a measure of His love for the world, so should we prove our faith and our love for God by giving as well. So as we gather to worship God on this day, let us not forget that giving is also an aspect of worship. So seek God for what you should give. Don't give just because, but give cheerfully from your heart because of your faith and love for God. Some of you might even want to give a special offering in honor of Mother's Day, and that is perfectly fine with us. But whatever your gift, large or small, we definitely thank you for your support, and we pray God's will over your life. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we first want to thank you for the privilege to give, and then we want to thank you for blessing us with seed to sow. We ask that you take our sacrifices, use them for the benefit of your kingdom, for the benefit of lifting life in the uttermost parts of the world. We thank you for what you're going to do, and we thank you for your faithfulness. Bless our gifts, bless the hands of those who have to give and those who have nothing to give. We'll be quick to give you the praise and the glory in all things. And we thank you now. We praise you now. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen and amen.
Hello, West Angeles, and happy Mother's Day. It is now my honor to introduce our leader and pastor, Bishop Charles E. Blake Sr., presiding bishop emeritus of the Church of God in Christ. Even during this time of separation from the church building and from each other, it has been his leadership that has enabled us to still be the church, even though we couldn't gather together to have church. Through his vision, we've been able to do so much to show the love of the Lord in these very trying times. It has always been his desire that God's people would be blessed as much outside the walls of the church as they were inside the church building during our worship. We've also been so blessed that we've been able to have him home and all to ourselves after serving extraordinarily for 13 years as the presiding bishop of the Church of God in Christ. We know that there is so much more that God is going to do through the life and vision of Bishop Charles E. Blake Sr. Let's give the Lord praise as we are now greeted by our leader, Bishop Charles E. Blake Sr.
First, I want to honor and celebrate all the ladies, especially all the mothers. We thank you and praise you for the vital, indispensable role that you play and have played in our lives. At the end of every phase of creation, the Bible repeats Genesis 1:10, and God saw that it was good. God and the Bible's judgment on God's work was that it was good. But after the man, Adam, was created and he started his life's journey, God observed him and said in Genesis 2:18, it is not good. It is not good that man should be alone. God said in the words of the Living Bible version, I will make a companion for him, a helper suited to his needs. It was after God said this that he created woman. Years ago, a young man by the name of Charles Blake set out on a journey of life and ministry. The Lord looked down on those early days and said, not good. It was not good for that young man to be alone. I'll prepare a companion for him. He placed his hands on a young lady by the name of May Lawrence, the daughter of the late Bishop and Mrs. Elton Lawrence. She is a graduate of Wayne State University, and she is a school teacher by trade. She's the former First Lady of the Church of God in Christ International and the present First Lady of West Angeles Church. She's the interior designer of the beautiful cathedral and most of the buildings on our campus. She's the mother of Kimberly Blake Ludlow, whose husband is Martin. She's the mother of Assistant Pastor Charles Blake II, whose wife is Deandra, and the mother of Pastor Lawrence Blake, who is a young adult pastor, whose wife is Janine. Lady May is the precious, beloved wife of Charles Blake Sr., me. I left her next to God with all my heart. She is an anointed woman of God. And so be blessed as you hear the voice of my sweetheart, Lady May Blake.
I've lost some good friends along life's way. Some loved ones departed in heaven to stay. But thank God I didn't lose everything. I've lost faith in people who said they cared. In the time of my crisis, they were never there. But in my disappointment, in my season of pain, one thing never wavered, one thing never changed. I never lost my I never lost.
Can I testify a little bit? Now I went to the doctor, and the doctor told me that I needed surgery to remove a large tumor, and that it could be cancerous. But I kept on praying, and I kept on praying. And when the surgery was over, there was no cancer found. Thank you, Lord. Tried to stop it and tried to tell me I'd never record again, but he's a liar. So excuse me for a minute while I make the devil mad. Can I make you mad? Help me say
I never lost my hope. I never lost my joy. I never lost my faith. But most of all, I never lost my praise. Praise God. Bishop Blake, thank you for that beautiful introduction. How wonderful, gracious, and inspiring you are. And I, as well as all of us here at West Angeles, have great admiration and respect for you, sir. Well, hello to all of you out there. You know, I miss you so much, and we will see each other and be together very soon. Now, we are all impressed about the technological advances that are available in our day, and this it's almost like being in the same room. So let's pretend that we are in the same room, because I would like to have a nice little friendly talk with you. Now, the song that you have just heard is lovely. It's beautiful. Not just because of the gorgeous voice of Tremaine Hawkins, but because it's a testimony, a precious testimony. She is singing about that special moment when you have made it through the storm and you look back in relief and even amazement, crying tears of joy and thankfulness that you made it. Not only is this a song of praise and a song of victory, it's a battle cry. It's a standard of encouragement. We can sing this song in the midst of our trials today because we made it through all of the trials that have come upon us this past year. You're right here now, aren't you? Now, you may not look like what you have been through or how you want to look right now, but you can say you look much better than the way you looked before. And we can say, praise God for that. So you made it through some things, and you will continue to make it through this pandemic. During this difficult time, that beautiful song, I Never Lost My Praise, I Never Lost My Joy, I Never Lost My Faith, I Never Lost My Hope, gives us steps or strategies to make it through our painful times. Now, here's the strategy, and you will be surprised at how simple this is. Like the song says, never lose your hope, never lose your joy, never lose your faith, and never, 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 ever lose your praise. Few of us could ever have imagined or even suspected that such a terrible tragedy like this COVID-19 would strike the earth. Almost every family has been impacted. This has been a time of unprecedented trouble. God's ways are not our ways, yet He can be trusted. Even when things seem chaotic, God is still in control. God wants what is best for us. And then again, unfortunately, some of you may have lost loved ones during this pandemic, either because of the COVID virus in particular or because of other conditions. It has been hard for you and devastating to cope with such a traumatic loss. Because of life and the many obstacles and setbacks that we encounter, there comes a period in our lives when troubles, difficulties, and certain issues in life can hit you so hard until they slam you to the core of your being and come up on you like a mighty storm. Now, I recently heard a touching song by Willie Nelson that is dealing with the pain and loss of a loved one. And it says, and I paraphrase, when you lose someone you love, and you feel that there is no way to go on, but love is bigger than us all, and the end is not the end at all. And this song goes on to say that this devastating loss is not something that you get over, but it's something that you can get through. Now, this may not only have to apply to death, but this can apply to the many traumatic devastations that you experience in your life that is so painful that you feel that there is no possible way to get over the pain or the hurt. But we know that with God's grace, we can get through our dilemmas because there is someone who walks with each of us through our dark periods, through our dark tunnels, helping us to climb our mountains, and that someone is Jesus. Even though we don't get over certain conditions, but with God's grace, we will get through them. Praise God. Since we have been through such a period of sickness and death during this pandemic, I would like to share and reiterate these strategy points of wisdom on how to prepare for unfortunate moments and trouble which will inevitably come our way. No one is exempt from trouble, pain, deprivation, unhappiness, sickness, or death. It does not matter if you are healthy or unhealthy. Everybody is vulnerable and will experience moments and even hours of misfortune and difficulties in your life. So a way must be found to cope with the negative things that will come our way. We all have to endure trouble in life. Sometimes we may go along for a while with just common irritations and then wham! Like, where did that come from? A big problem hits just like this coronavirus pandemic or some other big mountain of a problem. But things can cause us to grow. Laughter, joy, faith, gratitude, and praise. And these things can make us stronger, but we can choose to gather to our hearts the thorns of disappointment, failure, loneliness, and dismay. Or we can gather the flowers of God's grace, unbounded love, abiding presence, and unmatched joy. Pain is inevitable for all of us, but we have an option as to how we react to the pain. It is no fun to suffer. In fact, it can be awful. We are going to have pain, but as someone said, misery is optional. We can decide how we will react to the pain that inevitably comes to us all. Now, having a proper attitude works wonders. Life can be difficult, but we have a choice as to how we respond to the difficulties in our life. You might wonder, how do people continue to hope? Or, as it has been said, how do you keep hope alive? Anything you keep alive, you got to nurture. Speak life to yourself. Surround yourself with people, with friends, words, and music that will bring joy, strength, and life to you. The Bible is full of accounts where it looked like defeat was imminent, but God. You may have to take a break from some people. You may have to take a break from the news. You may have to let your favorite show on the television go. The choice is yours. Ask yourself, do you want to win? Do you want to endure? Hope is essential to make it through life. Hope means that we are trusting God to get us through troubles. It is believing that the hard times will pass and that the hurt we are enduring will be healed. Hope is a lifeline to sanity, a beacon of faith we follow through the dark places that occur in our lives. God takes all of our pain, our broken pieces, and messes and turns them into hope. Remember, no matter what you are going through, it did not come to stay. It came to pass. Oh yes, oh yes. Tears and sorrow may come, but each time God will be there to remind you that He cares. The good man does not escape all trouble. He has them too. But the Lord helps him in each and every one. How do you keep joy alive? Joy is not related to what you have or don't have. Joy comes from knowing that you are loved by God. It doesn't matter what comes into your life or leaves. It doesn't matter who comes into your life or leaves. You are loved by God just as you are. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. And all things, no matter what it looks like, are working together for your good. That is something to be joyful about. You are loved and everything is going to work out if you choose and can believe that it will. This is faith, and this faith will continue to invigorate your joy. And from this joy can only come praise while you are still fighting because you already know how the story will end. So it is important that we determine that we will not be defeated and destroyed by anything that we face. As you know, it rains on both the just and the unjust. Being saved and spirit-filled does not exclude you from pain and trouble. It does not exclude you from emotional and mental stress. Pain and trouble can be characterized as mountains. COVID-19 has been a mountain for all of us.
God did not create these type of so-called mountains to give us difficulties. We live on an earth where things happen for all types of reasons. If there is a tornado or a hurricane, it is not the anger and rage of a loving God. It is simply the weather system of the earth. Now, the difference between you and someone without a close connection to God is how you respond and react to challenges. All things work together for the good of those who are called according to His purpose. We too can rejoice no matter the circumstances. We can trust no matter the outcome. We are complete in Jesus alone and His steadfast love and faithfulness. We too can say, as in Habakkuk 3:17, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. During this painful time that we are in now, we can sing joyful praises to God because we are counting on God to prevail. We can take heart, gain strength, run like a deer, as in Habakkuk 3:19. The Lord God is my strength. He will make my feet like deer's feet, and He will make me walk on my high heels. We can run over high heels, elevations, and climb that big mountain of pain, sickness, disappointment, and trouble that is right in front of you, because God's love is so much stronger than whatever troubles you. Whatever your dilemma may be, just hang in there. Because God has you covered, you are a strong woman. He has a protective shield around you that will allow you to endure anything. Nothing can touch or happen to you in this life without passing through God first. Praise God. Praise God. He has reviewed, He has evaluated, and approved every pain, every difficulty, and every disappointment. Negative things happening to you are not accidents to God because He guides our lives. Romans 8:18, heaven's delight will far outweigh earth's difficulties. You know, when God permits us children to go through the furnace experience in our lives, He keeps His eye on the clock and His hand on the thermostat. And to all of the women in this internet audience, God has endowed each of you with a special beauty, a special style of your own, special abilities, and gave you a strength that is unparalleled. You can face any challenge that may come upon you because God has endowed you with not a double portion, but a triple portion of resiliency that gives you the ability to endure any and everything that may befall you. It allows you to stand under pressure. Because of your faith, because of your consecration, you will gain great favor with God. His fresh anointing will rest upon you, and the beauty of holiness will radiate from you and surround you like a shield. And no darts from Satan can break through because of your consecration. And as you develop a deeper intimacy with God, there will be special periods of visitation by the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah! 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 Praise God! Praise God! Praise God! Praise God! As He calls you to that special place of nearness to Him, where you have entered into His precious and glorious privilege, God alone is our source of joy. He can take the awful, hopeless situations, bring joy, greater faith, ultimate praise, satisfaction, and contentment. He takes the broken pieces, the pains, the messes, and turns them into hope. Jeremiah 29:11, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. Isaiah 4:31, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. and they will walk and not faint. And woman of God, and woman of God, you will emerge as one of God's superstars because you are a strong and magnificent woman. Enjoy the moment or position that you are in. Be happy that you are alive. That really is the secret of enjoying, receiving benefit and value to your life. You know, we can learn to be satisfied and contentedly in the moment. We can learn to enjoy each day such as it is. Life is so fragile. Life is so uncertain. Live each day as though it is going to be your last, because one day it will be your last. So be grateful for the gift of life that God is giving you each day that you wake up, and make that particular day a masterpiece with love, kindness, and service to others. Thank God and give glory to God for you. Never lose your hope. Never lose your joy. Never lose your faith. But most of all, never lose your praise. Now, don't allow this song to simply be something that you just sing. Your life and your actions should personify this song. Don't allow the words to simply be a report of your past. Allow hope, joy, faith, praise to be the marching orders of the day. And as you move into the future, allow this daily strategy of hope, joy, faith, and praise to ensure your battle victory. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God concerning you. And remember, we know that all things work together for good. Every joy and every sorrow is guaranteed to be for your good. Now, to summarize what I have said to you today, I will just use the words, hallelujah, anyhow. Hallelujah, anyhow, in the midst of sickness. Hallelujah, anyhow, in the midst of a job lost. Hallelujah, anyhow, in the midst of trouble. Hallelujah, anyhow, in the midst of mental and emotional stress. Hallelujah, anyhow, in the midst of any misfortune. Now, my prayers are going up for each of you. And may God continue to shower his wonderful blessings upon each of you. And just remember, hallelujah, anyhow. And right where you are, just raise your hands in gratitude and give God a hallelujah praise. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
What a wonderful message we just heard. I want to thank Lady May for her most inspiring presentation. As she spoke, I was reminded of an analytical report by a psychologist in which he said the suicide rate among those who had no religious faith was 5 times as high as it was for those who were active followers of the Christian faith. Having heard Lady May as she encouraged us today, it's easy to understand how this can be true. Her words are full of faith and full of life. God bless you, Lady May, for giving us strategies that win. Now, please stay logged on until the end of our program for a special presentation. May I present Sister Darlene Smith, and happy Mother's Day to all of you.
Thank you for staying with us. I am looking forward to worshiping with my West Angeles family once again under this roof very soon. But hang on. I pray that all mothers everywhere felt honored on today. We have one last treat to further express our love and appreciation with a final tribute titled, A Letter to My Mother. Enjoy.
A letter to my mother.
Dear Mom, God did not consult me when he chose you to be my mother. I had no say in the vessel God would knit me together in, and I did not advise him on where I should be fearfully and wonderfully made. And when he formed my inmost being in the secret place, I was not given a choice on what mother I would want or need.
Yes, some may see the mother to whom you're born as the product of completely random forces, unplanned and merely coincidental. They may call it a purely natural phenomenon. They may call it chance.
But having a mother like you
There's only one thing I can call it.
Grace. It was grace that gave me a mother better than I deserved. A mother whose kindness and compassion were the steady refuge of my youth. A mother whose joyful presence and warmth turned our eternally unfinished house into a home full of life and love.
It was grace that gave me a mother who faithfully taught me the difference between right and wrong and spared not the rod when I foolishly forgot. That has been a garland of grace that, even when I have sometimes run from it,
has remained firmly fixed around my head and my heart. It was grace that gave me a mother who stood behind all my biggest dreams, encouraging me to pursue my passions and to fan into flame God-given gifts. A mother who sacrificed weekends to support my every interest, no matter what it was. A mother who sold more cookies and candy bars for the fundraiser that I asked to be a part of. She sold, and I took the bow. I still owe you that mansion, I promise you, too. I ain't forgot.
It was grace that gave me a mother that made me proud to be called a mama's girl. With a mother like you, that's the highest compliment a woman can get. While for some, being a mama's girl made me, and it's still making me, a woman of sensitive strength, quiet courage, and unflinching hope. Or as you like to put it, all my good qualities come from you.
And it was grace that gave me a mother whose stubborn love never gives up on me. A mother who keeps believing that God will use me even when sometimes that's hard for me to believe for myself. A mother who persistently prays for me, and a mother whose unwavering support is the sure foundation on which I stand in every season of my life.
No, I did not get a say on who my mother would be, but if I did, there's no one on this green earth that I would choose besides you. So on this Mother's Day, and every day of my life, I thank God for the grace of calling you Mom.
I love you, Mom.
Happy Mother's Day. Your son, David Hunter Jr.
Your daughter, Stephanie.
Your son, Eric.
Your son, Al.
Your daughter, Keisha.
Your son, Donnie.
Do you ever wonder if you're here for a reason? Do you ever feel alone, but you're not quite sure of where to turn to for help? If so, then know that West Angeles has classes, workshops, and one-on-one sessions at our counseling center, and we invite you to join us. Whether you want to be a better spouse, a better parent, or just a better you, the West Angeles Counseling Center is proud to provide you with supportive programs and counseling for the whole family from a Christian perspective. We offer invaluable classes and workshops such as our grief support groups, our premarital and parenting classes, our married couples fellowship, and so much more. You have been fearfully and wonderfully made. And we'd love to support you and your family on the journey to optimal mental health. To learn more about our programs or to schedule an appointment,
please contact the West Angeles Counseling Center at 323-737-7463 or email counseling@westa.org today. You don't have to be a West Angeles member to benefit from our services. And remember, we're connecting because we care. And please come back tonight as our celebration of Mother's Day continues. You won't want to miss our dynamic speaker for this evening's Mother's Day service, the magnificent and anointed evangelist Lisa Nevels. Happy Mother's Day.
Let us pray. Father God, I just want to thank you. Thank you for all the blessings you bestowed upon us just today alone, for waking us up this morning. We thank you. Clothed in just our right minds. We thank you. Thank you, Father God, for allowing all of us to see another beautiful Mother's Day. But I especially want to thank you for all the mothers and the many women who have stood in as mothers when biology could not. You who became human through a woman, grant to all the mothers the courage they need to face the uncertain futures that life with children brings. Give us the strength to love and be loved in return, not perfectly, but humanly. Give them the faithful support of their husbands, their family, and friends as they care for the physical and spiritual growth of their children. Give them the joy and delight in their children to sustain them through the challenges of motherhood. Most of all, give them the wisdom to turn to you in times of trial. And we will thank you because in the midst of this storm, we know who is in control because you are God all by yourself. We ask, Father God, that you cap your angels, grace and mercy alongside us this week as we work to uplift you and to do your will. We ask this all in your name, Father God. And I truly, truly believe that all the peoples under the sound of my voice would join me in saying thank you and amen.